and gentlemen, Gungans, Gerard, Ganymede, Conan, Holsters, and Blasters, and put your hands together because it's time for YouTube's favorite show, Well of Fame! How you doing? High five. High five you. High five you. Dang! Woo! It's great to be in the Empire today. We got the hater to fuck because we are wearing the finest Gucci and gold in the wardrobe, and of course, we got the Beskar Crocs, and let me tell you, Galaxy Vier has a lot of stuff for us to talk about today. Of course, of course, of course, we will have a brief Will or Phil episode because I've been getting a lot of questions since an update last night regarding all of these packs. I know you're tempted. You got some Master Kenobi fever. Should I buy the Watt Tambor pack? What about the Kenobi Negotiator pack? We'll talk about that towards the later part of this video, but we have some other stuff I want to talk about today with you. You might have missed it. We think we got our first little teaser at the next Galactic Legend paired along with Master Kenobi, Lord Vader. Developer's words, not mine. That's the name they're using. And we got to talk about somebody who said Bad Batch becoming farmable. I want to talk about them very briefly. I think there's a bigger future ahead of them. And right before we get into this whaler field, I want to talk about Master Kenobi. How much energy is going to be roughly needed? And I'm going to be sharing one of my biggest secrets in case you haven't seen it in the past. How do I already have 36,000 energy hoarded up? My gosh. But before we talk about all that, we got to talk about our sponsor, Gary. Hit it. Whaler fail on the wall. Who's the sponsor for them all? Raid Shadow Legends! So we're going to talk about the top five best Raid Shadow Legends characters that you should be keeping your eyes peeled for. Coming in at number one, Carjell. Holy cow, this guy is bonkers. And he's got a mass cleanse capability. So we have Bad Alcazar. Allowing your allies to do more damage against poison. And the basic attack attacks all enemies and heals this champion all allies by 20% of the damage inflicted. Coming up next, we have Dracomorph. And this character right here is going to do more damage for each debuff on a target enemy. Archmage Helmet. This guy has tons of ways to feed turn meter to your team, has ways to resist turn meter removal himself. And last on our list, we have the Runekeeper Dazzlerk, representing the dwarves. And he's got a mass cleanse capability that heals your allies. If you thought these champions look amazing, you gotta come play Raid Shadow Legends this month because they have many more brand new champions on its way with a bunch of summer events and on top of that, a new rotation of the Doom Tower. I have another great champion that you can get for free if you scan my QR code or go to the links down below in the video description. And if you're a new player, you'll be getting an epic hero, Chunaru, 200,000 silver, 1 XP booster, 1 energy refill, and 1 ancient shard. All this treasure will be waiting for you right up here, but you gotta be quick because these rewards are only available for the next 30 days. All right, let's get on in. So before we get into the packs, we got a couple of those big things I wanna break down with you all. First, these packs, long story short, not a huge fan of them, but I understand if you guys are hitting that Kenobi fever hard, you might be pursuing these packs. We'll talk about that momentarily. Let's hop on over to the Imperial Tactical Display. The other day, we had the Kenobi Master, Master Kenobi Kirvil. You probably saw it right about now. We'll put a card right up there in the top right-hand corner in case you missed it. But there were some developer insights released shortly after that mentioned a certain character. Now, there's been some speculation and debate what it's going to be. I think more and more and more we're starting to see it's not going to be anything else except a new Anakin Skywalker. But the developers called it out specifically. It looks like the name of this next GL is gonna be Lord Vader. Anakin Skywalker died the moment he became Lord Vader. So if you're excited like me, whoo, just wanna put that out there because some people might be hoarding, they like Kenobi and all, but they are kind of looking forward to what this next GL is gonna be. And there is confirmed another GL coming along with Master Kenobi, but there's some speculation if it's gonna be Maul or Grievous. I don't think it's gonna be those, especially since we're gonna be going in Mustafar battling Lord Vader. I think it's all but inevitable. Lord Vader's going to be that next GL. So that's the first thing I want to put on your radar. Next up on the list, officially, as of yesterday, holy cow, time flies when you're dominating the holotable in the galaxy. Let me tell you, Hunter is starting to become free to play farmable. Light side, 5B hard. Never a fan of hard nodes. That's kind of a fact of reality that we face at this point. But the reason why I want to talk about this for a moment, Bad Batch fantastic team. Even with only a team of four, you can plug in a lot of stuff in the fifth slot. They can underdog plenty of teams out there. We've done extensive testing on it. But the reason I want to put this on your radar, because we are slowly starting to get all of these characters free-to-play farmable. Attack should be coming probably sometime next week, and then Wrecker afterwards, and probably by the end of the month, early July, you're going to be getting Echo as well. And I think, especially because Bad Batch is coming to a close in August, this gives us 2 months, a month and a half or so to start farming all these characters free-to-play, and I think there's going to be something down the road. Worst case scenario, you're farming a top 10 team if you're pursuing them. I mean, we've been doing a lot of 3v3 testing, and holy cow, people seem to be scared of this team on defense. Here's my Hunter, Wrecker, and Echo taking out a Padme team and surviving with full health and full protections. And people have been throwing gas at this team because they don't want to screw around. There's one gas takedown right there. Here's another battle right here. I'm sure in time we're going to find other counters to these things, but people are not trying to underestimate these teams. They're throwing big ticket items at the Bad Batch crewers. So keep your eyes peeled. Get ready to start farming these characters. Bad Batch is the real deal. Top 10 team. Loving what they can do. And I think there's a bigger future. If you've been following the Bad Batch, which I've been enjoying, I think there's easily going to be one more character down the road, perhaps for an August or September release. Now, let's come back to the conversation of Jedi Master Kenobi. We are all facing the fever, and I want to talk about how much energy is going to be needed. I've been getting this question nonstop. It's been like 8 months since we've had our last Galactic Legend. Thank you, Gary. Here's a little summary of, in general, it's a good estimate for how much energy. If you're someone that wants to start hoarding, you should have been hoarding the other day when we got the confirmation that Jedi Master Kenobi was coming on June 16th. You should have already been making the progress to start stockpiling your energy. And I already have 36,000 energy. Well, how you got 36,000 when you only have 541? Well, hold on, young Padawan. We'll talk about that momentarily. But coming over here, big shout out to Darth Bang. Actually, a little bit of research when this discussion was kind of fresh off the press. This is a good estimate that I think you guys should put out there. Long story short, to just unlock the GL, you're looking at about 8,400 energy. And this is assuming no crashes when you're doing a Galactic Legend attempt. And furthermore, no failed attempts on your part. So in general, this is probably a rough idea. So if you're someone hoarding energy, you should probably get started soon, because that is a ton of energy to hoard up. And in general, if you want to get the unlock and ultimate day one, you are probably looking around 25,000 energy. You guys don't need to debate with me. I am not a fan of the Galactic Legends ticket system. I think it's one of the worst things in the game. It's not a satisfying feeling when the game crashes or you lose and you got to spend like a whole extra couple days just to redo that battle all over again. We will be doing this event day one to try to help minimize the stress on you guys. So be sure to come on over to the biggest and deadliest Star Destroyer so you can see how the Master Kenobi event is going to roll here. And with that in mind, let's start with the last two topics here. How the heck do I already have 36,000 energy poured up? I bring up this topic every time Galactic Legends comes around the corner. I'm not sponsored by these people at all at Google Play, but ever since I came across Google Play Points, if you're someone that wails on the game, even just a little bit, I highly recommend you do not wail on iOS if you can try to avoid it. Android emulators are completely free. Nox, BlueStacks, Mimu, there's a lot of Android emulators you can download on Mac and PC. Anytime I want to wail, I do it on a Google Play or on an Android emulator, because every time you wail, you earn Google Play Points. And with Google Play, man, oh man, they have exclusive offers solely for Galaxy. So as you spend money, you get these Google Play Points up here and you can redeem them for these little enhancement kits. I'll redeem one of them right now for you. But basically, this 150 point pack right here gives you 150 energy. So it's a 1-to-1 ratio, which means I have over 37,000 Google Play Points saved up. And right there, without really even trying, I already have a ton of energy hoarded up for Jedi Master Kenobi. There we go. Congratulations, you just successfully redeemed your Google Play Points. This is an official relationship between Google and CG. This isn't some backdoor thing that I'm showing you, Ryder. This is a legitimate thing that CG, Galaxy Heroes, and Google Play have worked out. And as you see, and besides just the energy, you're getting some crystals, you're getting some credits, which is whatever, you're getting some slicing materials, you're getting stun cups. I mean, this is valuable stuff right here, and I feel like it's not talked about enough. I talk about it at least once or twice here, and there we go, 150 ship energy, 150 normal energy, automatically claimed. So I'm not gonna really hoard too hard, but if you're someone that doesn't whale then yeah, you probably want to do the manual hoarding where you just buy some energy in advance, do your 50 crystal energy refresh. But if you are someone that spends even a couple bucks a month, you should really look into Google Play, because unfortunately, iOS, Apple, they do not have that type of relationship with CG Capital Games. Finally, let's do a little bit of a pack review here. Oh, man. Here's the thing. Really, there's no good packs in store. I'm not going to spend that much crazy time talking about, all right, $4.99. Yeah, the crystals kind of put you right around that $4.99 valuation, and you get some gear. I'm not going to talk too much about this. Not a crazy deal, but if you are someone that already buys crystals, you're getting some gear along with it. So might as well go with that. It's not something I'm going to buy. It's not a meaningful pack. I've been actually wailing a lot less. There hasn't been much taking my attention, except when a new character comes around. But there is one pack I'm kind of a frequent customer for. These packs. We've been seeing a lot of these mod hauls. I think there was a speed one just last week. We talked about mod packs in the past. I am not a huge fan of them. $4.99, yes, at least it's not a lot of stuff. You're getting 12 mods. Problem is, when I buy these packs, I never get any good speed out of them. Speed is pretty much the most important thing. But I do want to mention this. This might be helpful for the upcoming Jedi Master Kenobi team. We've done a kit review breakdown. His kit is a lot about bonus protection, which is calculated based off your max health. So I have a suspicion max health mods are going to be very important when you consider Caddy Mundi amplifying max health even more. And then Kenobi's lead doing that as well. Health mods probably help, but you don't need to go out and buy the pack. If you're looking for speed and health mods, chances are you might get something out of this. It's completely random. It's literally pulling a slot machine, seeing what you get. $4.99, at least it's not like 50 bucks or something. If you want to roll the dice, go for it, but just be wary. You're probably not going to get anything that amazing out of it. But if you do, hey, congratulations, my friend. And now these are really the packs that are up for discussion. Man, oh man. There's also, you can already see which pack I bought. We'll talk about that in a moment. I'm not going to break down each of these packs with the Kenobi, the Negotiator, Watt Timbor, and General Grievous. We don't need to go into that much of discussion. Long story short, you are paying a premium on top of a premium for these shards. We have these Kenobi packs right here. I gotta say this, I am slightly surprised CG is not completely opening the doors for this character to be available. Jedi Master Kenobi, that is. They're putting a purchase limit on all these packs for Watt Timbor, General Grievous, General Kenobi, and the Negotiator. I was really expecting, and we saw the data mine pull these packs out in advance. I was like, it seems like they're gonna make Watt Timbor available, but not 100% of the way. You're only going to get 30 shards if you buy this Kenobi pack twice. And I believe, what is it? This one gives out an extra 20 if you buy it twice. So in total, you can get about 50 General Kenobi shards. General Kenobi isn't really the problem when it comes to these Jedi Master Kenobi requirements. Chances are, if you don't have General Kenobi, you are very far behind in the process for getting Jedi Master Kenobi. And it's going to cost you a lot of money to get it up and running. So even in my free-to-play account, it's been going on for, 4 or 5 months? At this point, and I already have General Kenobi unlocked. So General Kenobi is not really a crunch point. I don't see the reason why you want to go and get him, because you need him at 7 stars and relegate. So I would advise not to buy this pack. I'm trying to find why would you want this, unless you're just someone that's not in a good guild and you just want to unlock Kenobi, go for it. But just know, premium shards in my valuation at most are 80 shards per crystal. Premium characters. This character, you're paying over 100 shards per shard. So you're definitely paying a premium plus to get Kenobi. And unfortunately, Kenobi's not really the big grind point. It's the relics, Watt Timbor, and perhaps the Negotiator. Moving on to the Negotiator, $40 for 20 blueprints, man. Holy cow. You can buy it twice. You can spend $80 on 40 blueprints. Yeah, they kind of make it a little bit more manageable because they give you 1250 crystals, but still, you're paying a major premium on the Negotiator. Luckily, you only need a 6-star Negotiator. But keep in mind, if you're someone trying to get Master Kenobi right away, a GOTB is going to be up and running in a few short minutes. So it depends what type of guild you're in, how much guild event token 2 currency you're getting as a result of these GOTBs, if you're able to participate in it. If you do this GOTB, which should be completed before Jedi Master Kenobi comes live inside of the game, I would say assess afterwards whether or not you need this pack. I'm going to advise against it because chances are if you need it, you have a lot of other stuff you need to work up to in terms of relegates and whatnot. But if this is literally the last thing you need to get a 6-star Negotiator, and after this GOTB, you're a couple blueprints off, go for it. But you're paying a heavy, heavy premium. Not a good deal. It's how desperate are you to get Jedi Master Kenobi as soon as possible? This is really I think it's oddly enough, even though Watt Tambor has been out for 2 years, pretty much on the spot in a couple weeks here, not a hard character to get in terms of the event. I was able to get Watt Tambor mission completed with unreworked geos and at gear 11, gear 12, way back in 2019. Easy event. However, you need a Relic 7 Watt Tambor. And unless you've been in a decent guild the past at least a year to get Watt Tambor the 7 stars, you might be a little bit behind on this raider. But they only allow you to buy this twice for $30. And each purchase gets you 30 shards of Watt Tambor. So at most, I'm surprised they're not opening the valve all the way and letting you guys go crazy. You're going to get 60 Watt Tambor blueprints. So, again, there's this next GOTB, there is no Watt Tambor shards being distributed. This is a cam mission that we're coming up with, this GOTB, light side GOTB. So, we just had a dark side GOTB. If you find yourself in a situation where literally the only thing you're missing is a Watt Tambor at 7 stars, then, of course, bumping up the Relic 7, this is only for pure desperation. If you need it. If you're someone that doesn't even have Watt Tambor or a single shard, this isn't enough to unlock this character buying this pack twice. So again, this is, you're not getting a good value. You're paying a high premium for Watt Tambor, and you can't just do unlimited whaling and go from 0 to 7 stars in day one right here. I'm going to advise against it. But if you're literally 60 shards away from getting that 7 star, let's say you're at 40 out of 100 to get him to 7 stars, go for it. But just keep in mind, you then got to whale to get the gear 12 or gear 13. And then Relic 7 if you do not have the materials ready already. So you guys are kind of seeing the theme. How desperate are you to get these characters? And then we have this General Grievous pack. Holy cow, $40 for General Grievous. My gosh. Here's what I'm going to tell you guys. Let's hop over to the free-to-play account. I'm just going to say this right now. There's really no need to wheel out on General Grievous, even for $40. He's a little bit elusive inside of that fleet shipment store. But he's not impossible to get. And again, chances are, if you don't have General Grievous up and running at 7 stars at this point, even though he's been a top 10 team for quite a long time now, this isn't going to solve all your problems for getting Jedi Master coming. But I believe there is another pack that might offer a little bit more value. I believe, is it this character bundle right here? Let's double check. I believe it might be this character bundle right here. Which, no, that's not the one. There used to be another pack. They may have moved it away from us. There it is. I knew it was here. Look at this, night and day difference. Yes, of course, you're not gonna be getting all this gear. This gear really does not really add up to this valuation right here. You're paying a heavy premium, $40 for 50 shards of General Grievous. Nuh-uh. If you are someone that wants to get General Grievous unlocked or you need a lot more shards, go with this pack. Character bundle small, click on Grievous, click on find, $20. You'll get 80 shards of Grievous. You'll get 500 crystals to go along with it. And you get some assortment of gear, which isn't really as meaningful. But still, the point being is, if you're looking for General Grievous shards, this is a better pack to open up. And I say that lightly. So not a big fan of these General Grievous packs right here, even with the gear. And this right here, you only need General Grievous or Magna Guard to get Jedi Master Kenobi. If you're going for gas, still, even though all these characters are more or less required for gas, I would not go for it, of course, except General Grievous is not required for gas. You only can buy this pack twice, and it's so RNG. So I would advise, stay away from this pack. Even if you're desperate, Jedi Master Kenobi, look at your roster. If you're someone that's on the precipice of getting Master Kenobi ASAP within the first month, maybe consider it. But again, there's a lot of other better ways to get secret packs that CG does not want you to know about. And lastly, I've already bought this pack here. I'm a frequent customer of this pack. I do not whale that much in Galaxies right now. Not a lot entice me unless there's a new character to review. Relic Challenge Bundle. Besides Watt Tambor Negotiator and those being the two main problems, the third problem is a Relic 8. Only way to get Relic 8s in the game is either through a challenge rank raid, which requires a very good guild, lots of Relic 5 characters inside of your roster, and then, of course, Conquest. But if you are not doing well in hard mode Conquest, you're not going to be getting Relic 8 stuff. So literally the only other way to get Relic 8s is through the Relic Challenge Bundle. But do note, how many Relic 8s are needed for Jedi Master Kenobi? 2. You need a Relic 8 Jedi Master Kenobi, and what's the other Relic 8? Grandmaster Yoda. So between General Kenobi and Grandmaster Yoda, 2 Relic 8s, and let's say you have 0 Relic 8 pieces, buying this 3 times only gets you 30 of these arrow magnifiers right here. And unfortunately, that is just not enough to get 2 Relic 8s. Now, if you're someone that's in a challenge Rancor Raid Guild and you already have a couple of pieces, let's say you already got 10 pieces hoarded up, buy this pack 3 times,
You're good to go. And at least I'm a semi-fan of this pack because you're getting arrow magnifiers, you're getting the impulse detectors, and these are hard to craft already. And you get a good amount of Zimbiddle cards and these Electrum conductors up here. So yes, this is actually kind of worth it if you're someone in the Relic 8 market or even Relic 7 for that matter, if these Zimbiddle cards. Only pack I've really bought out of these. And again, all these other packs you're seeing in the store, man, you got to look at it. If you're only a couple shards away or one GOTB or two GOTBs away, this Watt 10 board negotiator pack might be worth it, but that's not all of your problems aren't going to end there, pal. That Relic 8 is going to be a big one right there. So that's going to wrap it up for today. All you dang good looking ladies and gentlemen, Gungans and droids across the galaxy. I don't know if you look as good as me, but you probably are coming this close. Thank you so much for watching today. Leave a like if you enjoyed today's video. Comment down below on all your beautiful thoughts. And be sure to subscribe so you're not missing a thing. And get hyped and ready for Jedi Master Kenobi in less than 1 week. But until then, always remember, dang, it's great to be in the Empire today. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you later. Peace out.